that all glory and honor belongs to you. We pray, God, that you open up our hearts that we may receive what the Spirit of God is saying. In Jesus' name we pray. Thank God. Amen and amen. Amen. Just going to talk to you for a few moments, amen, about something that we all deal with. Amen. It's not something that, amen, it's something we all deal with in life. Amen. That thing is called pain. Have anybody ever dealt with pain in life? Amen. And see, one thing about pain, it doesn't matter on whether you're saved or not. Amen. Pain has a way of finding you. That's why the writer said that a man is born of a woman, is here a few days, and then what? Full of trouble. Amen. How many know that sometimes in this life, we go through things and we deal with things that sometimes make us feel as if we are all by ourselves. Sometimes we go through situations, we go through different circumstances in life that makes us feel as if, God, where are you? And it seems like sometimes that nobody understands your pain but you. But I heard the songwriter say one time that if you don't have no pain, there won't be no gain. Come on, somebody. So pain doesn't come to hurt you, neither does it come to stop you from moving forward, but it comes to teach you more about the God that you serve. Because there's something about pain that will teach you that God is a healer. See, somebody knows what I'm talking about, because somebody's heart's been broken before, and you didn't know that God was a heart fixer until you cried when your heart was broke. You didn't know that God could mend the broken heart until you got to a place where you felt the pain, when you got to the place when you felt empty on the inside, and God showed up and let you know, not only am I a burden bearer, not only am I a healer, but I'm a heart fixer. Come on, somebody. Not only am I a heart fixer, but I'm a mind regulator. I got power to do exactly what it is that you need. Me to do so. Something about pain that we deal with. Amen. Sometimes God allows you to go through things and folk will watch you while you go through it. Come on, somebody. Amen. Because your life now is a living testimony of what God can do. And so sometimes you go through things and people see your struggle and people see your pain and they see the things that you're going through. And instead of them coming up to you and giving you an encouraging word and giving you something, amen, that you can stand on, the first thing that they start doing is looking at you with a judgment spirit. Come on, somebody. I wonder what she did. I wonder what she did to be going through this. And I wonder what he did to be going through that. Amen. But I believe it was your brother Job. Come on, somebody. That didn't have no idea what was getting ready to happen to him. He wasn't there when God and Satan had the conversation. But the conversation was all about him. See, but God had enough inside of Job to let him know, amen, that he won't curse me. Amen. He told them, I'm not going to think I'm forsaking him. Amen. But he's going to be right there. Come on, somebody. Amen. When it's all said and done. So then you can do whatever it is you want to do. Amen. You can allow pain to come to his house. You can allow pain to come through his family. But I guarantee you, at the end of it all, he's still going to be right there with his hands stretched open. Say, Father, I stretch. Come on, somebody. My hands. Help that I know. So sometimes we go through some painful type situations, and sometimes we left with the question that says, Lord, why me? Amen. Why am I the one that have to go through this? Sister Johnson, you've been there. We all been there, especially as pastors and leaders. We ask ourselves the question, why, Lord, did I have to go through this? And why are you letting them run me down like this? Why are you letting them do me like that, God? You said I belong to you. But it seems like every time I make one step to move forward, somebody always got something to say about it. But God always come with a word and said, if you guys keep on moving forward, I'll never leave you, nor will I forsake you. And I'm so glad that when everybody else walk away, I got somebody that I can call on in the midnight hour. Come on, somebody. And they ain't gonna push no ignore button on me, Brother Walker. They won't ignore me, Brother Walker. And then God will be right there. Right there. Sometimes God allows you to go through things. so that your life can be a testimony that says, if it had not been for the Lord, that was on my side. The Bible says that Paul was on his way sailing with the brethren going to Rome, and something happened on the ship. The Bible says that the angel of the Lord appeared to Paul and said that this journey will be with much strife.
Come on.
He said this voyage will be much danger ahead, but I want to let you know, Paul, that you don't have nothing to worry about, because I have my hand around you. And so Paul began to speak to the men that were on that ship, to those amen, that was controlling the ship, and telling them what was to come. Amen. They looked at Paul as if he was nobody. Come on, somebody. Amen. You don't know nothing about sailing. You don't know nothing about the sea. I got this thing here. We ain't never had a problem like that. Come on, somebody. It ain't no problem. Matter of fact, I'm looking on the radar, and for the next 5 days, I see nothing but clear weather. Paul, you don't know what you're talking about. Sometimes the word of God goes beyond. Y'all better hear what I'm saying. Goes beyond your natural mindset. That's why John said, I use the voice thing to confound the wise. And so Paul began to tell them what was to come.
Come on.
They didn't listen to him. They shipwrecked. The word of the Lord came and said nobody would be lost. Not even one hair on their head would be lost. The Bible says that they shipwrecked.
Come on.
They swam to shore. And when they got to shore, come on, somebody, they came to a little mountain called Malta or Malicia, however you want to pronounce it. And the Bible says that they were so cold from the weather that when they came, amen, to the land, amen, the barbarian people met them. Come on, somebody. And they met them and made a fire. The Bible says they showed them no little kindness. I'm in the book of Acts. They showed them no little kindness. And they began to light a fire. And they began to tell the men that was on the ship, come around so that you can keep warm. Come around, amen, so you can keep warm. I know you just got out of that cold water, and we just want you to be warm. And they begin to light the fire. And the Bible says that while they were, Paul was gathering up a bundle of sticks, and he began to reach down with the bundle of sticks, and out of those sticks came a viper, and it latched on to Paul's arm. And the barbarian people that was of that town, of that island, amen, they looked at Paul as if he should have fallen down dead suddenly, because the people on that island knew, amen, what type of animals and what type of beast was on that. And they knew that once somebody got stung or bit by the venomous beast, that it wouldn't be long before they'd be dead. And they began to, begin to wonder, my God, amen, though this man have escaped the sea, vengeance suffered him not to live. And the Bible says that they looked at the beast hanging on Paul's arm. And Paul did one thing that you and I gotta learn how to do. The Bible says that he shook off the venomous beast and felt no harm. Come on, somebody. And they thought that he should have fallen down dead. But how many know that when God got a plan for your life, how many know that when God's got something in store for you, I don't care how folk try to destroy you, I don't care how circumstances try to knock you back, when God has a say so about it, amen, he said that I'm not a man that I should lie, nor the son of man that I should repent. If I spoke it, what's your point, preacher? My point is, there comes a time, Pastor Bendy, when you got to learn how to take the pain and still remain. Come on, somebody. I know it's some folks that want to see you down, and I know they looking at you going through your trouble, but you got to learn how to take the pain. Come on, somebody. But when it's at the end of the day, I'm still going to be standing, amen, because the God that I serve, he's on my side. And I read in the Bible somewhere where he said, if God be for me, who can be against me? So you got to learn how to take the pain and still remain. Come on, somebody. Amen. I know it hurt, but I'm still going to stand. I know it's painful, but I'm still going to stand, Brother Walker. I know sometimes these old legs sometimes say, I ain't going to church today. I can't take them, but you got to take the pain. Come on, somebody. And say, if I can just get to the house of God. I know you got a little headache. And I know it's painful, but you got to learn how to take it and get to the place of where Jesus is, because he is well able to take the pain. You should never let pain get in your way of getting to the place where Jesus is. Come on, somebody. You should never let pain. And the most pain that we deal with, it's not so much a headache. It's not so much arthritis, though it hurts. It's painful. But the worst pain a person could have is with somebody that you trusted. Y'all better hear what I'm talking about. The worst pain that you could have is that when it's somebody that you confided in and somebody that you looked up to and they said, I'm your friend and I'm going to be with you, only to find out that everything that you told them is from the top of Facebook, come on somebody, to the bottom of Facebook. And now you stuck with the shame and pain is in your heart. Y'all better hear what I'm saying. That's the worst pain that you can feel. That's why you sung the song, if I had wings, I'd fly away. See, David was dealing with some pain. Come on, somebody. He was dealing with some pains that wasn't from the enemy. Come on, somebody. But he said it was somebody, my equal. It was somebody that went to church with me that hurt me. It was somebody, even that I rode on the church van with that hurt me. And it was that person. Come on, somebody. But you got to learn how to take the pain and still remain. You got to do it. Hurt sometimes, but you got to shake it off like Paul did. Amen. I know y'all done heard that before, but there comes a time, Pastor Bendy. Amen. When you just got to shake off stuff. Amen. I know it hurt because I've been there, Brother Ann Walker. Amen. It hurts when folk are scandalizing your name. You don't even want to go to the store. Come on, somebody. You don't even want to go check your mail because your next door neighbor, child, is that you? Girl, guess what I heard? Call somebody. So it makes you want to stay in the house. But there comes a time when you got to look yourself in the mirror and say, I don't care what's been said, from hell or high water, God is on my side, and he's worthy. See, that's the trap of the enemy, is to get you balled up, and to get you balled down, and to keep you isolated, and keep you in a place where I'm just nobody. Nobody understands me. Nobody want to be my friend. Honey, there comes a time when you say, you know what, friend or not, I'm the child of God. And if God is on my side, though you may walk away from me, I got somebody that's with me always, even. That's the enemy. So pain hurt. When it comes from somebody, that's a significant factor in your life. You expect the enemy to do things. You expect that.
Come on,
somebody. If there's an enemy that's doing it, you don't have no problem with it because you expect that out of them. Come on, somebody. But what is when it's somebody that you talk on the phone with every night? Well, what if it's somebody that you tell all your problems to? That's why you can carry it to Jesus. Oh, y'all better hear me. You can take it to Jesus, and you ain't got the way about it.
Come on, come on.
That'd be it. Scripture said, take your burdens to the Lord.
Uh-huh.
Ain't that what the song said? Take your burdens to the Lord.
Uh-huh.
And leave them there. It's painful sometimes. That's just life. Come on, somebody. It don't matter whether you say, see, the difference between you being saved dealing with pain is you got something to look forward to. Come on, somebody. The unsaved person, when they go through it, they don't have nothing at all to look forward to. But we got something to look forward to. Guess what it is? It's the victory, honey. Because victory shall be yours.
Good.
You gotta learn how to hold your peace. Where you hold your peace is when folks get on your nerves and you ready to crank your chains off. I don't know who, come on, honey. But see, real Christian, we don't crank our chains off. Come on, somebody. We set the chains all down, dog. I ain't gonna let the devil make me lose my character. I ain't gonna let the devil make me come out of what God called me to be. See, that's what he wants you to do. He wants you to be so in pain that you lose your character and lose your integrity, lose your cool. And the first thing you gonna hear, child, I knew it wasn't nothing to him. Did you hear how they was cursing? Did you hear how they was doing? I knew they wasn't about nothing. See, but when you use wisdom, come on, somebody. Wisdom teaches you to do what? Come on, somebody. Wisdom teaches you to wait. Wisdom teaches you to hold your peace. And then while you're waiting, what you get? Come on, somebody. And then when you get an understanding, you can get up and speak with confidence. Come on, somebody. Because you heard the full matter of the situation. You gotta learn how to use twist. Because the whole job of the enemy is to destroy your testimony. To destroy your character.
That's it.
To destroy what God is building up in you.
Yes, Lord.
His whole purpose. See, because he understands that greatness is upon you. He understands that greatness is upon you. And he, what he wants to do, if he can destroy that, all you have to do is, amen, submit yourself to God. And he'll take the pain. Don't let the pain be the thing to stop you from moving forward. We all go through things. We all go through things in life. But the old folks used to say, and I said this morning, that the church is the saints' what? Hospital. And if you can't come to church with your pain to get relief, something wrong. Come on, somebody. Because in reality, everybody that come to church, we ain't got it all together.
Come on, somebody.
We come because we need something. I don't come to church just because it's the thing to do. I come because I know that I can't make it without Jesus Christ. And the Bible says that it's the word of God that will keep you. And it's the word of God, guess what? You got the healing. Come on, somebody. Faith comes by hearing what?
The word of God.
Come on, somebody. Faith comes by hearing.
That's it.
So you got to get to a place where the word of God is being preached.
That's right. Come on.
And what that does is that it ignites faith in your life. To move forward and to move over every obstacle that comes in your way. Don't let little things stop you. You know what? We deal with one another. You don't live in a vacuum. You don't live by yourself. You deal with people. I say all the time, you can't be in ministry and not deal with people. Ministry is all about people. Though they may get on your nerves sometimes, God didn't call you for you. He called you so that you can be a light for the people. Come on, somebody. I believe it was Moses that got tired of it. Come on, somebody. God had to let him know, Moses, I equipped you for this people. Come on, somebody. I know they're getting on your nerves, but I'll call you. I gave this thing to you, and you got to be obedient in spite of what the folks do. Well, talking about the building, it ain't nothing like you preaching and then and you putting out stuff out there that God give you for the people to do and nobody cooperate. That's frustrating. See, but when you've done what God said you could do, you can shake the dust. Y'all better hear. You can shake the dust. He said, all day long, I've stretched forth my hand to a rebellious generation. We're sending. Amen.